Well, joining me now is best-selling biographer and Tulane University history professor Walter Isaacson, author of The Codebreaker, Jennifer Doudna, Gene Editing and the Future of the Human Race. Walter, it's so great to see you. I've been so excited about your new book and to talk to you about this. You've, of course, written award-winning biographies of Albert Einstein, Steve Jobs, others. Why did you choose Jennifer Doudna?
I do think that the advances in the life science revolution, and I didn't even think about the way vaccines would become genetic, but that's, of course, one thing. But advances like gene editing and making molecules something we can reprogram like we do microchips, I just thought that would be the biggest revolution of our time, even bigger than the digital revolution. And then I met Jennifer Doudna. And as you said in the introduction, she has this great life story. You know, she persisted to become a scientist after her school guidance counselor told her, girls don't do science. Then she focuses on RNA when all, you know, a lot of the male biologists were focusing on DNA. And then she and Emmanuel Charpentier win the Nobel Prize for this groundbreaking thing, which allows us to edit our own genes.
Now, can you explain what CRISPR is in layman's terms for all the non-scientists, including myself out there? I mean, it's something that bacteria have been doing naturally for, you know, millennia. But how
well,
is
if, it yeah, if bacteria, if bacteria have been doing it for a billion years, it can't be all that complicated because they're not much smarter than we are. What they do is they simply take a mugshot every time they get attacked by viruses, you know, a little snippet of the genetic code, and they weave it into their own DNA in these clustered repeated sequences known as CRISPRs. So if that bacteria ever gets attacked again by that virus, it knows how to chop it up and destroy it. In other words, it's an immune system that adapts to each new wave of virus, which is clearly something we could use in this pandemic. And what Jennifer Doudna and Emmanuel Charpentier and others figured out was, oh, we can repurpose this because if bacteria use it this way, we can re-engineer it so it will cut our own DNA at a target that we specify. So CRISPR is a gene editing tool using RNA as a guide to chop up our genes wherever we tell it to.
Now, let's talk about the ethical concerns, the difference between helping to cure Victoria Gray, the woman in Mississippi with sickle cell, by doing it to someone who has suffered from this mutation, the sickle cell mutation, and doing it in utero with a fetus for inherited genes. Is that the distinction between what was done in Mississippi and what this Chinese scientist did?
Absolutely. And it's an important distinction. When Jennifer Doudna helped create this technology, she had a nightmare, which is that somebody wanted to meet her and learn about it. And she goes into the room and the person looks up and it's Hitler. And she realizes that in the wrong hands, especially when you do inherited genetic edits, ones that will be passed down to children and to all our descendants, you know, editing the human race, that could be definitely misused. So part of the book is Jennifer Doudna, along with other scientists, ethicists, religious leaders, all gathering, including with the Chinese who arrested that doctor after he did it, so we can try to find rules of the road and probably a line that we'll draw that says, unless something's truly medically necessary, we definitely should not make inheritable genetic edits. We can make mistakes, it's unsafe, and we don't want to mess too much with the human species. So I think this is the type of thing, you know, your people like Tony Blinken and Jake Sullivan are in Alaska in a couple of days to talk to the Chinese. They've got a lot they're going to fight over. But I think they'll put some things on the list that we should cooperate on, and I hope CRISPR's at the top of that list.
Now, just to play devil's advocate for a moment, after all the suffering of this horrible year with the pandemic, if you had the choice, if scientists had the choice to genetically edit the coronavirus out of our systems, out of the systems of future children, future generations, would that be worth it? Or again, is that,
you know, I love,
you know, playing God in a bad way?
I love the way you ask that question, because we should open our minds a bit, because I think Jennifer Doudna, a lot of people in my book, including myself, had sort of an adverse reaction to the Chinese doctor editing a receptor to a virus. But after the past year, you have to at least do the thought experiment, which is, well, what would be wrong if we could do it safely to edit our species to be a little bit less susceptible to viruses? And I think, you know, sometimes when I talk about how dangerous this could be in the wrong hands or whatever, I'll start getting plaintive questions from people who say, you know, my 12-year-old granddaughter has this genetic disease and they think she's going to die in 3 years. Or my son is crippled because of this and his muscles are atrophying. So I think we have to be open and not just have the knee-jerk reaction that gene editing is bad. We have to say, what are going to be the rules so that we can do it ethically? And maybe that includes making us less susceptible to viruses as a species. I mean, heck, if bacteria are allowed to do it and every other species uses every trick in the book to make themselves safer, maybe we should.
Well, you've done it once again, Walter. Leonardo, Einstein, Steve Jobs, you're always ahead of the curve. You're always writing about invention, creativity, genius. And we're just so grateful. Thank you for coming today. The book is The Codebreaker, Jennifer Doudna, Gene Editing and the Future of the Human Race. Thank you, Walter Isaacson.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. You should know that you can follow today's top stories and breaking news and catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.